this is an episode that kicks off with a very, very scary haunting. A bunch of kids wandering through the woods, lost, come across an abandoned barn. They go into the barn and some very scary things happen. There's something going on. There's some mysterious haunting, some mysterious ghost, and it seems to be tied to an unsolved kidnapping case that's about a decade old. What happens is you've got a very, very angry ghost punishing anybody who comes close to a story, and our characters have to keep going back there looking for answers. And not just looking for answers, but looking for treasure that may or may not be hidden there. You know, this is an episode about money being the root of a particular evil that dates back years and years and years. Multi-layered sort of tragedy in terms of where it all came from, because it ironically stemmed from the efforts of family to sort of insulate their child from the evils of money. Basically the sort of irresistible temptations of money. A lot of lessons are learned, but too late. A lot of people ask if there's a formula to writing these stories, and there isn't. You can't make it too easy because life isn't like that. Each episode is a sort of unique challenge because you've got to find a way to introduce a character who are like detectives. They're like emotional detectives, and they're following clues in a mystery. A little bit about what happened to them and how they got to where they are, and usually we're talking about ghosts. But there needs to be a certain amount that's a mystery to not just to the audience, not just to people who care about them, but a mystery to them, things that they don't understand about themselves, about what got them where they are. And what's hard is figuring out how to tell a story that gradually reveals those answers and that makes those answers feel earned. So there you have it. I'm P.K. Simonds. Please tune in to Ghost Whisperer Blood Money this Friday on CBS at 8 p.m. Can you see us?